Hi guys, Nvidia started the super refresh of its Turing lineup during the summer, and we managed to present you the 1660 Super just the other day, and we now finally we get our grubby mitts on the GeForce RTX 2070 Super, which in difference of the original 2070 is based not on TU106 but on TU104 silicon that is the same used in 2080 and 2080 Super. So what's so special about it? It has 2560 CUDA cores, 256-bit memory bus to 14,000 megatransfers per second GDDR6 memory, 8 gigabytes of it, and it has base clock speed of 1605 megahertz. The max boost clock in this case it is gigabyte WindForce OC variant is 1815 MHz, and this is the card. It has 3 fans, 5 heat pipes, pretty large radiator, but it's just a bit above 2 slots. 3 display ports, 1 HDMI connector, and it has nice backplate, and the backplate is in fact connected through a thermal pad with the PCB on the VRM and memory sides, so it actually does something useful except for looking good. So we're going to throw this video card in one of our systems and see how it performs. Let's start. For the testing, we decided to make a quick comparison with Radeon RX 5700 XT, and later in the month you will have a much larger comparison of graphics adapters in that class. So 2070 Super against Radeon RX 5700 XT. The performance of the 2070 Super is a bit higher in almost every game, sometimes bordering to the noticeable 10%, and sometimes in case of the Battlefield 5 and Red Dead Redemption, going a bit, tiny bit below the performance of 5700 XT. On average, you can expect 4-5% better performance from the Nvidia adapter. But the MSRP of 2070 Super is 20% more. So, is it a good buy or not? Well, if you are buying a whole system, as the one we have recently built in the Cougar QBX Mini ITX case, that 20% will be mostly diluted in the overall price. In our case, if we change the 2070 Super with 5700 XT, you can expect 6-7% difference in the price, so it's pretty much on par with the difference in performance. Then it largely depends on the games you play. If you play some of the games where 2070 Super is faster than 5700 XT, it is also a good buy. But if you want just the best price performance, 5700 XT is the better choice. That's it for now. Like if you liked it, subscribe if you want more, And if you want, you can support us on Patreon.